Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. Joining me right now is Zach Bradford, CEO at CleanSpark. Zach, great to see you. How are you?
Hey, I'm doing great. Thank you for having me today.
Zach, an interesting day today as CleanSpark has acquired a Bitcoin miner called ATL Data Center. Could you tell me a bit about them?
Absolutely. Yeah, we're excited about this one. ATL Data Center is unique. And the reason we picked them out is as part of our growth strategy, we wanted to have a test bed. And we went and we're looking at companies that had very high energy use profiles and ways where we could directly monetize energy and not only improve our technologies, but create a very significant return on investment. And we looked at a lot of different places and a lot of different industries. And it was a really great fit for us. So we really look at the acquisition as one where we can turn energy into cash.
Yeah, can you maybe talk specifically about how the ATL Data Center will assist in your initiatives to be more energy efficient?
Absolutely. So on site, everybody knows that Bitcoin mining uses a lot of energy. And, you know, mining also gets thrown around. So I want to, you know, to our energy investors, I want to speak a little bit towards the fact that, you know, Bitcoin mining is really just getting paid to process data. And the form of payment just happens to be in Bitcoins. So, and the cost for that data processing is power. And what we are going to do there is what we do best, and that is help reduce power bills. So they already have a fairly good power rate at the location, and we're going to drive it down further to increase profitability. Right now, the site is producing, you know, 1.4 Bitcoins on average, which, you know, there's variability in how that works per day. And we're going to increase capacity. So we're going to take the facility from a 20 megawatt facility up to a 50 megawatt facility. We already have the contracts in hand to get that done. And, you know, we should be at full capacity, hopefully by the end of April is the timeline we're looking at. Once they're at full capacity, we are going to start to add microgrid assets. And we are going to take our strategies and we are going to put one microgrid that handles a segment of the business and have it focused on, for example, cost savings. We're going to then add a microgrid that is focused on greenhouse reduction and clean energy to try and take a portion of those, mining computers and pull them all the way off the grid. And then we're going to have another one focused on resiliency. So always having backup power at all times. All these microgrids are going to interlink so that if they need to share power, they can. And it's all about creating lower energy costs to increase the return, but also having a demonstration facility to really prove out what we do best. So this is very much exactly us staying in our lanes of being an energy company. The facility will be run semi-independently. It will be wholly owned and under the purview of management like myself, but the team is coming with it. You know, the data center staff, they know what they're doing, and they're gonna keep doing what they do best. And it is profitable, and we're really excited about adding those profits to the companies.
Yeah, definitely an exciting acquisition here. So, I mean, following your recent $40 million capital raise, are there any other acquisitions that investors should look forward to on the horizon?
Absolutely, we're still on the hunt. We said in our press release this is the first of this year. We haven't of course announced any others, but we are still pursuing, and those pursuits, rather than being test cases, they're actually, you know, other software and energy acquisitions we're pursuing. Some of those are in due diligence. Some of those will work out. Some of those won't work out. But we are still pursuing those. So this is just what we expect to be the first acquisition of the year. We do expect to have more in the future.
Well, congrats on this latest one, Zach. Thanks so much.
Hey, absolutely. Thank you.